Buffalo Fanatics, what's going on? It's the Kingpin. Look, first, before I even start this video, I know you guys had the Chick-fil-A lemonade. Hands down, best lemonade you're going to have. But here's the kicker, though. If you add some sugar-free Red Bull inside this bit, man.
Ooh,
but I wanted to make this video just to explain the reasonings as to why I chose Landon Dickerson and Tommy Tremble as my first two picks in the 2021
Buffalo Fanatics founders mock.
To me, it was simple. It went back to what Brandon Bean said after the season and what Brandon Bean said last week.
Yeah, I think it's unfair to look at the running backs to point blame on the running game. I think running the football is very complex, and it's the obviously the O-line, it's the tight ends, it's the receivers. And if one guy doesn't make his block, the play's probably dead. And so there were times this year where we're one guy away, and whether it's a tight end, whether it was a lineman, and it's a big gainer, and you're going, gosh, if we just get this guy blocked, and we had that at times.
He pretty much said, look, it wasn't the running backs. It was more so the blocking or lack thereof from the offensive line and or tight end. You bring the entire offensive line back. You let go of our best blocking tight end in Lee Smith. And it makes me think,
okay, maybe
the idea is to replace those with draft picks, high draft picks. So in enters Landon Dickerson, first team all pro that has played both guard positions and was named the best center in all of college football. I know it's not sexy to go offensive line. I get it. Everyone wants the flashy running back or the elite wide receiver. But Brandon Bean has said multiple times that the key to building a consistent winner is to make sure the trenches are always top priority. And then last week, Brandon Bean said this.
At the end of the day, at 30, we're going to try to take the best football player we could take. We really are. And you know, you'd love to say, hey, this guy's going to come in and start right away day one. But it's going to depend on which position it is. I do think there are some positions, if it worked out that way, that maybe not definitely start, but you could say this guy's got a shot. I think there's some other guys that we have on the board. We're going, this guy's one heck of a player, but he's not going to start day one, but we will count on him. And maybe in a year, he's going to be the starter. We'll have a player that's on a, you know, the last year of their deal, and so he'll kind of back up that player, learn from him, compete with him, but we don't necessarily expect him to start. So we'll think long term more than short term, but you know, we'll see how it goes. It'll be a good player.
I said, look, I'm not in the business of trying to get a day one starter. If he ends up becoming one, then so be it. But I'm not necessarily going into the draft trying to find one. I'm more so trying to get a guy who can learn from a starter and eventually become that guy. Now, as far as tight end, many may say,
but we don't need a tight end.
If you look at the tight end room, you may think twice about that. Dawson Knox, a tremendous talent, has all the potential in the world, but he just hasn't panned out yet. Jacob Hollister, a solid tight end, I'll give him that, but he's just solid, and he's only on a one-year deal. You have Reggie Gilliam, who's an unknown, and then you have Mr. Unknown and Tommy Sweeney. Tight end is actually a bigger need than you think. I not only picked the guy who is an elite pass catcher at the tight end position, one of the best tight ends in all of the draft, but I specifically chose Tommy Tremble because he's the
number one blocking tight end in all of college football.
There were times this year where we're one guy away, and whether it's a tight end, whether it's a lineman.
So why not fix that with the first two picks and just make sure that next year the offense doesn't take that regression and the lack of a running game is no longer an excuse. So what do you guys think? Does it make sense to go O-line in the first and tight end in the second, or am I just overthinking this thing? Let me know in the comments. It's the Kingpin and I'm out.
Golly.